हेलो एवरीवन, नमस्कार। आई एम सोमनाथ शर्मा। माय एकेडमिक क्वालिफिकेशन इज क्लास 12 AISSCE पास इन द ईयर 1989 एंड प्रोफेशनल क्वालिफिकेशन इज TTI इन 1994 एंड आई हैव 30 इयर्स ऑफ एक्सपीरियंस इन टीचिंग प्रोफेशन। I am from West District of Sikkim. The West District of Sikkim lies between 27 degree north latitude and 88 east longitude. It is the second largest district of Sikkim. The district has a large Nepali population and Nepali language is the predominant language of the region. This district is the site of the ancient state capital Yuksam. I teach in government secondary school Lungchuk in primary level, and there are 133 students in my school, and they all belong to rural background, and even today a few number of students are first generation learner. Most of the parents of the rural students are farmers. Due to the very reason, the students are not getting the proper guidance from the parents. Some students have to walk for about 1.5 hours to reach school and takes the same time to reach their homes after school. So it is very difficult to teach the students in rural areas, as the school of such areas facing many problems in comparison with the urban areas schools. ZIIEI, in collaboration with SDFC Bank Limited, conducting a webinar to facilitate the teachers about NEP 2020, IPCT, online teaching, etc. In this ZIIEI training program, Mr. Swayandeep Song has been given as our facilitator, who is very experienced, enthusiastic and supportive too. In this webinar, our facilitator made us known about number one, NEP 2020. Our Union Cabinet in July 2020 approved the new education policy NEP, which aims at universalization of education from preschool to secondary level. Number two, IPCT. ZIIEI promotes and supports the experiential teaching environment through innovative Pathshala. Innovative Pathshala is a series of innovative tools for primary teaching. Number three, online teaching. Online teaching and learning is faculty delivered instruction via the internet. Online instruction includes real time and anytime, anywhere interactions. Number four, Bloom's taxonomy. Bloom's taxonomy is a classification system used to define and distinguish different levels of human cognition, that is thinking, learning and understanding. Number five, concept mapping. Concept mapping is a visual organization and representation of knowledge. It shows concepts and ideas and the relationship among them. Number 6, pictorial representation. It is the information presented through pictures or symbol of different objects. The pictures of different objects are used to represent different informations. When I attended the ongoing online webinar organized by ZIIEI, then I realized that how I can improve the learning outcome of my students without investing any money. In the innovative Pathshala training session, I understood that I need to engage my students in experiential learning to make a better learning outcome in my classroom. I received a lot of benefits from the webinar. From the webinar, I understood that there are so many innovative ideas, or those ideas already in my mind, which I could implement in the classroom, teaching, and even in the online classes, but I did not know the way how I can implement in the classroom. So our trainer, that is the resource person, Mr. Sayandri Som, has helped me a lot to improve the ways and techniques of teachings to implement and to improve these innovative ideas already in my mind. In my classroom teaching, every week I do role plays and group activities by dividing them into certain groups. I give roles to my students and they divide the work among them and start playing their role so that they can remember the lesson and they can finish the chapter very easy. So I can confidently say that such activities can help other schools also, and I strongly say that my school should be chosen as one of the role model school of the West District. Lastly, I would like to thank Sri Aurobindo Society, ZIIEI, for providing us with such a very, very useful online webinar. And in other side, I would like to thank HDFC Bank Limited for providing funds to Sri Aurobindo Society for providing such a useful training to the teachers. And please like, share, and subscribe the video. Thank you.